الحمد لله وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Just a reminder, because of the incidents nowadays, the fact that the Christians mock our Prophet and our religion, this is something which Allah said clearly in Quran, that they take your religion as an amusement and mockery. And this is one of the reasons that Allah mentioned when He ordered us to declare hatred for them, saying, why do you take as allies those who make mockery of your religion? You see? So when it comes to this, this is not something new. Okay? And Allah says, وَدُّوا لَوْ تَكْفُرُونَ كَمَا كَفَرُوا فَتَكُونُونَ سَوَاءَ. They wish that you become non-faithful like them, or you become with them in the false faith, so that your fate will be the same in the hereafter. You will not be better than them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, do not take my enemies and your enemies as allies. You see? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, they are my enemies, okay? And they are your enemies. So no Muslim should be surprised by those things. Yani. This is one thing. Another thing is, they are making mockery of us because actually we are in a state, as far as our faith is concerned, most of us are very far away from practicing the faith. We are very weak in practicing the faith, and we are also at the top of that very weak materially. You see, we are divided, all kinds of small countries, and you know, Muslims in one country are 10 groups at least, 10, 20 groups in some places, more than that, okay. And this shows that our situation, يعني, we are helping the kafirs to mock us, okay. And also the fact that we are not practicing the religion of Allah and the orders of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a kind of mockery also of the religion of Allah and the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yani, it's a big mockery when you say that our religion teaches us to be truthful and you are 99% of your time lying, especially when you are buying and selling and dealing. It's a great mockery. Just like someone who puts a big, you know, good-looking plate behind him on the wall saying, fear Allah. And he is sitting underneath it. And, you know, saying all kinds of things which Allah does not like. Backbiting, lying, cussing, saying bad things, you see. So it's a big mockery for this, you see. That's why some scholars said, you cannot put those things on the wall. Because some ignorants say, oh, what's wrong with that? We are putting Quran, okay? We are putting a verse. What's wrong with that? What's wrong with that is that you are mocking Quran. You are putting this great sign to be aware of Allah, and you are not aware of Allah the least. You see? Maybe you are working in a bank. So this by itself is a great insult for taqwa, that you have put a big sign there. Plus that you are, maybe you are mixing with women in your work and lying and cheating and all that. Why? So this is the point, that we Muslims should know first that if we show respect for our religion by acting upon it, and we show respect for our messenger by following him, and we show respect for the Book of Allah by following it, then the enemies will respect us, you see. We have tried it. Yani, I went to America when I was 18 years old, studying in the Language Institute. Those amongst us who were not practicing Islam, not praying properly, not yani, acting upon Islam properly, they were the most exposed to the humiliation from the Kafirs over there. And those amongst us who had some practice of Islam, pray on time, when it's prayer time they go and pray and all this, they were respected by the Kafirs. You see, I've seen this by my own eyes, and I have experienced it by myself, you see. And that's the situation. We Muslims have to respect our religion so that they respect us, you see. You can find people whose religion has no value and nothing, okay? But because they are practicing it, they are forcing respect upon the others. Yani, they are forcing others to respect them and to respect their way, even though their way is nothing. Yani. It has nothing to do with the truth, you see. Another thing is that, as I mentioned earlier to the brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has guaranteed in his book that he will take care of those who mock our messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, إِنَّا كَفَيْنَاكَ الْمُسْتَهْزِئِينَ. O Muhammad, we have guaranteed you support, and we are enough of support for you against those who mock you. Mock you or your religion. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ شَانِئَكَ هُوَ الْأَبْتَرُ. The one who says bad things about you, he is the one to be cut and to be punished. And this happened in the time of the Prophet ﷺ. The one who told the Prophet ﷺ, you are such and such, and he was saying bad things about him, Allah punished him in that time by being killed in the first battle between the Muslims and the Mushriks. And the companions of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when they were during the battle, and they hear sometimes the Mushriks mock the Messenger or say bad things about the Messenger, they would take it as a sign of victory. They would say, now we are more sure of the nearness of the victory and the quickness of the victory. Why? Because of those verses that we mentioned, and because they have faith in Allah and trust in Allah, and because they are practicing the religion. It's not just like people nowadays. They are the furthest from following the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and yet you find them in situations like this. For some reason they get emotional and they do all kinds of things, okay? The Muslims should not tie their hands, because this is not the way, okay? And yani, our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, supposedly, as Muslims, we should give up our lives for him, okay, and for his sunnah. And similarly is the Book of Allah and the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We should give our lives for them. We should give priority to the love of the Messenger to the priority to the love of ourselves. This is an obligation. This is not something which is favorable. No, this is an obligation. This is part of our faith. So it's our duty to do what we can. But this does not give us a pass to do wrong things, because ends do not justify means.